عند الإشارة تكون الساعة 7 صباحا.
هنا رباط إذاعة المملكة المغربية.
That was embarrassing. The US have just been cooked by Morocco in the Olympics. What the hell is a mile? 4-0, bro. 4-0. The US have been cooked. Oh my god, this is it. I'm telling you, but we're winning it all. When I tell you we're winning it all, Spain, Japan, doesn't matter who's next, and we'll see France or Argentina in the final. That's fine. They had us dancing. They had my boy Ezel Zuri dancing. They had Elias Akhumar dancing, bro. This, it was too easy. I was looking at a tough game because I respect the US. I am American as well. At the end of the day, I'm Moroccan American. So I had respect for my other, for the American side. Another goal for Rahimi, even if it was the penalty. And Elias Akhumar, even he scored a goal. What a goal. The play from Ezel Zuri to keep the ball in and the pass to finish it. They even had Hakimi scoring, our right back scoring, bro. This US keeper needs to be investigated, bro. This brother Hakimi passed the ball to the net. They can't stop us. They won't stop us unless they want to cheat us. If they want to cheat us, the only way they can stop us, bro. We'll see, bro. Spain, Japan up next. This is football heritage. First, you make history in the World Cup. Semifinals, soccer, we make it against France. We lose to France in the semifinals. Now the Olympics. We're doing it in the Olympics, bro. The world stage. When it's the world stage, Morocco always shows up, bro. This is prime golden generation Morocco. And I am here for it. I told you. Who's next? It doesn't matter who's next. Give me anybody. Even if it's my boys, Fermin Lopez and Kubasi, we will be there.
Well, Morocco just embarrassed the United States soccer team, winning 4-0 and making it look really easy. So that eliminates the United States for now.
ثلاثة يا فخر يسعد قلب المغرب اقسم بالله فخر يا المغرب 3-0 على امريكا لا يا المغرب صدمتوني ديما مغرب رفعتوا راسنا يا ابطال رفعتوا راسنا يسعد قلبكم 3-3 على امريكا ايش قاعد بصير مش قادر اصدق شو اللي قاعد بصير 3-0 والكل مغرب على امريكا 3 لا 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 يا حكيمي لا يا المنتخب المغربي كووهم شووهم اكلوهم بسجدوا الابطال هذول هم فخر العرب المنتخب المغربي رفعوا راسنا 3-0 على المنتخب الامريكي يسعد قلبكم يسعد قلبك يا حكيمي ولك والله انك فخر وبطل والله لا 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 يا اخوان 3 على امريكا على امريكا انتم مصدقين نصف النهائي يا حكيمي يا حكيمي يا حكيمي يا بطل يا حكيمي لا نصف النهائي يا أبطال.
Well, that was an absolute embarrassment of a game from the US. All credit to Morocco, fully deserved. They deserve to freaking embarrass us like that. We did not show up at all. Like, Morocco wanted to be there and play, and we just we just showed up, to be honest. The energy, like the want to play was just not there from anyone. And then the commentators were saying that, you know, oh yeah, their legs are heavy and, you know, they're tired, they've had a lot of games. So have Morocco, and they played almost like 20 minutes of extra time in the first game against Argentina. That was terrible. Well done to Morocco. Fully deserved. They played far better than us. The combination play, they were toying with us. We were kids. Like, they were just having fun, you know, and they have a good chance of making it to the final. They're playing against Japan or Spain, two teams that I think they could clearly win. Like, they could clearly beat. That was a terrible performance. No one wanted to play. No words. Lost for words. We deserve to get destroyed. We deserve to get embarrassed. And time to go back home.
المغرب تتقدم على أمريكا بربع نهائي الأولمبياد. والله مو طبيعيين. وراح يسجلون الثاني وتذكروا كلامي. وراح يتأهلون النصف النهائي. والله مو طبيعيين ما شاء الله شنو هالامكانيات اللي عندهم لا 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 واحنا مستغربين فازوا علينا 3 قسم بالله رحمونا قسم بالله انا متاكد بين الشوطين المدرب قال لهم احترموا المنتخب العراقي امكانياته محدوده مع المدرب المحلي من الاخير
On that right hand side for Morocco there's a combination of three players Ashraf Hakimi we know how good he is but we also have El Khanous, who is the attacking midfielder, let's say, but he gets drawn into the play on that right-hand side. And Elias Akhomash, who is a Spanish-born Moroccan player who went through La Masia who's lighting it up this tournament. He is so skillful, quick, dynamic, has these sharp bursts of quality, of creativeness with heel flicks. And the combination on that side is where the U.S. is going to have to be very careful and either have either Dietz or Tessman slide over to help that out, because between Yao, Tolkien, they're going to have their hands full. Then on the other side, you have Abdeiz, who also played for Barcelona for a little while and is at Betis now. He, who is a very speedy winger. Today he scored, if you guys haven't seen it, go check it out. It was a golazo. Cuts inside on his right foot and just banged one behind the goalkeeper. Had, you know, knuckleballed it behind the goalkeeper. He's good.
The third one?
That was the third one. That was a 3-0. Yeah. And then you have the goal scorer of the tournament, Brahimi, who's one of the overage players who, you know, to the European eye, might not have a stellar career, but after he left domestic football in Morocco, Raja Casablanca, he went over to Al Ain. He's a Champions League winner. Not only that, in the 13 games that he played to get to the championship where they took down Al-Hilal, the Neymar team, the stacked Al-Hilal team, Hernan Crespo, by the way, led Al-Hilal team, excuse me, Al Ain team. He scored 13 goals in 13 matches. He's on fire right now. So they also have a striker. And last but not least, there's a kid called Amir Richardson on this team. Amir Richardson. Doesn't sound like a Moroccan name. Probably because it's not. His dad is American. Played in the NBA. His mother is French-Moroccan. He was born in Nice. And he's in the heart of this midfield team. So there's a couple of standouts on this Moroccan team that I would just be wary about if I'm a U.S.
ترجلين ما بين العزوزي وما بين بوكامير لإعطاء أكثر فرصة لريتشاردسون وخنوس وأنهم يكونوا متمركزين إلى الأمام ويعطي التمريرة الممتازة اللي تكون بين الخطوط حتى يعني يخلق الفارق. خنوس اليوم غير موجود، اللاعبين الموجودين أكيد فيه بالغرض، أكيد يعني عنده على البنك بن صغير اللي شارك في المباراتين الأولتين يعني كلاعب أساسي ثم توجد على البنك قادر أنه يكون موجود، ولكن المنتخب المغربي عموما على هذا المستوى اللي ريناه ما بين اللاعبين الأساسيين واللاعبين الاحتياطيين اللي نزلوا ما فماش فرق كبير يعني بيناتهم، كلهم يمتازوا فنيات عالية، يمتازوا بشخصية قوية خاصة، ويمتازوا أيضا بقوة العمليات الهجومية والسرعة في الأفكار. ونلاحظوا للاعبين المنتخب المغربي عندهم افكار منسجمه ومتناسقه، لان نشوف في هجمات كل اللاعبين فاهمين بعض، يعني تقريبا الافكار واضحه بالنسبه لكل اللاعبين في المنتخب المغربي. إيه؟ ان شاء الله بالتوفيق
يعني المباراة. التجانس واضح جدا يعني بالنسبه للمنتخب المغربي، لكن كابتن مثل هالبطولات المجمعه تحتاج دكه، والمغرب عندها يعني الدكه القويه اللي ممكن تلعب، ما شفنا عمليه تدوير كبيره، وكان بدا الضغط يكون على المنتخب المغربي.
اكيد اكيد الضغط، يعني انت تتكلم
كم تحن اربع مباريات 12 يوم؟
في 12 يوم بالضبط، فاكيد اللي راح يكون في المباراه الجايه اليوم رابع مباراه. المشكله المنتخب المغربي هو اللي حط نفسه في هاي الموقف، خاصه من هزيمته ضد اوكرانيا، كان لو فايز ضد اوكرانيا كان ضد العراق كان يقدر يلعب بالصف الثاني ويعطي المدرب التدوير بشكل كبير، ولكن هاي الوضع صار، فالحين لازم على اللعيبه يتحملون. اليوم حتى احنا قاعد نتكلم في عالم الاستشفاء، في ادوات تخليك تستشفى بشكل سريع، مش نفس السابق قبل السابق.
ان شاء الله راح اجي لكم كباتن، ولكن نرجع الان للزميل وسام. تفضل يا وسام.